Hello, my name is Colt Correa. I work for Intrepid Control Systems, the company that brought to you the book, Automotive Ethernet, The Definitive Guide. And this video will explain zonal network architecture in 5 minutes. Here we go. Past and existing network architectures, often referred to as domain architectures, group networks and ECUs together based on their function within the vehicle. For example, there's often a powertrain network that controls the engine, transmission, alternator, and other parts of the vehicle associated with propulsion. Other functional domain groups could be heating and cooling, lighting, and body control. Data between these groups are often transferred through what is known as a gateway ECU. Domain architectures have served the industry well. However, with the continuous growth of the number of electronic features, the number of ECUs and the networks along with the associated wiring also grew to the point where this has become a major contributor to the cost and weight of the vehicle. This is because many domains span the entire vehicle, and therefore, so do the wiring, ECU, and electrical system. Wiring for the different domains, such as HVAC, lighting, body, overlap each other, leading to very costly and heavy wiring harnesses. New zonal architectures seek to improve the situation by networking ECUs, actuators, and sensors together, not based on their function, but rather based on their location, hence the name zonal. Zonal controllers are distributed in the vehicle and aggregate the data to and from the edge devices that are physically nearby. The aggregated input and output data then is sent to and from a sort of super brain within the vehicle called the central compute module. In a zonal architecture, intelligence is moved away from individual ECUs into the central compute module. The devices on the edge become mostly smart actuators and sensors, not making decisions by themselves, but leaving that to the software in the central compute module. This architecture approach not only reduces wiring and the number of ECUs, but also provides a good platform for a software-defined vehicle, which is a goal of most OEMs. The transformation from domain to 100% zonal architecture will not happen overnight. Safety critical systems such as ADAS and systems that require high network bandwidth like infotainment are likely to remain separate for a while into the future. Mixing high bandwidth infotainment data along with safety critical data and other vehicle data on the same network between the zones will take more time to develop and verify given the associated risks. Relatively recent developments in automotive network technology have enabled zonal architectures to be developed. Most important is a wide range of two-wire automotive Ethernet technologies, including the new 10-based T1S, which is a bus-based or multi-drop technology designed to compete with legacy networks such as CAN-FD and FlexRay. Additionally, we have a wide range of point-to-point automotive Ethernet ranging in speed grades from 100 megabit all the way up to 10 gigabits per second. Ethernet addressing and routing capabilities enable data frames to be automatically routed from a source to destinations without the need for software. This is taken care of by Ethernet switches and is built in the hardware. Numerous Ethernet protocols also exist for automotive applications, including gPTP, which enables time synchronization across an entire network with accuracies lower than 1 microsecond. Transport layers such as IEEE 1722 enable audio, video, data, as well as legacy network data like CAN-FD, LIN, and FlexRay to be transported across the network. Other AVB and TSN family of protocols enable real-time communication on Ethernet with safety-critical options like redundancy. Open Alliance has standardized methods such as TC10 and TC14 for ECUs to sleep and wake up for power management. Adaptive AutoSAR and Classic AutoSAR enable software from multiple vendors to coexist and function inside Linux-based ECUs or ECUs with other real-time operating systems. This is a necessary part of a central compute module. Also widely available are numerous cybersecurity technologies that have been proven to protect against attacks. TLS and DTLS can be used to authenticate and encrypt data in and out of the vehicle. MACsec is a point-to-point cybersecurity method that can protect all traffic on an Ethernet network. It supports both authentication and, optionally, encryption. These technologies combined with the appropriate Ethernet switch policing and filtering ensure a secure vehicle network. All of these technologies mentioned provide the framework for a reliable, fully functional, and secure zonal network architecture. There you have it, vehicle zonal architecture in 5 minutes. Intrepid Control Systems has been in the business of serving the automotive networking community for almost 30 years with the latest tools such as media converters, vehicle network adapters, in-vehicle data loggers, simulators, data analytics, and much more. Please contact your local office for more information. We thank you for your time.